My story starts at CERN, the biggest physics lab in the world. And as a particle physicist there, we use processing power from millions of connected laptops to solve trillions of physics calculations. This idea to use someone else's laptop to fund my research always fascinated me. But I'm not alone. It's been going on in the scientific world for the past 2 decades, with the Folding at Home project leading the race with over 1 exaflop's worth of computing power. This is distributed computing, and it inspired in me a powerful vision. Imagine if we could connect millions of GPUs together to provide affordable supercomputing to engineers, designers, and scientists to help them with compute-intensive industrial applications. How would our world change when we bring this from the scientific domain into the hands of the crazy ones? My brother Gaurav and I founded QBlocks to help the world transition to affordable supercomputing. On our way to developing exascale level capabilities, our first stop is making high performance GPUs virtually stackable and remotely accessible by others. But where do we find these GPUs? Well, during the gold rush of crypto in 2017, miners invested heavily in infrastructure to mine crypto like Bitcoin and Ether. But crypto mining ROI is a function of ever increasing mining difficulty, the cost of electricity, and of course, the actual value of the crypto token. But unfortunately, the 2018 crash in the crypto space rendered these powerful machines useless. Today, those same GPUs sit idle, looking for an income stream that is less volatile than crypto. With more than 2 million dormant GPUs out there, we can get quite far on just this supply. But we envision expanding our network to include Xboxes and gaming stations too. So why isn't everyone doing this? Well, creating access to a network of distributed GPUs is no easy task. First, we had to build a reliable connection with these remote machines while providing isolated Docker containers on each connected GPU to provide a secure development environment. Then, we built an abstraction layer to abstract and manage GPUs on remote machines automatically. Last but not the least, we developed outage protocols provide full redundancy and security of a user's data. And with all this in place, we had to outperform what was out there in the market today. So we performed a benchmark test using a popular computer vision neural net for 60,000 images, first on an AWS powered GPU instance and then on our distributed GPU setup. And this is where we realized the commercial promise of our product. Our system performed the same task in 1/3 the time and at 1/10 the cost of AWS. This enabled us to charge half the industry standard while providing double the earnings to the crypto miners and still make more than 80% margins at scale. But what good is having a supercomputer without applications to run on it? Well, at TechStars, we spent a lot of time understanding the computing needs of data scientists. So we focused our first application on making it super easy for them to run their machine learning models. Let me show you how this works. Using QBlocks is a simple two-step process. Spin up a GPU instance and then select a Docker image pre-configured with your favorite AI framework. And boom! In a few seconds, a network of powerful GPUs is at your service to process your heavy AI workloads. I would end this with a conclusion. 20th century was the era personal computers. 21st century will be the era of personal supercomputers. Democratization of supercomputing will unleash a new level of innovation and creativity in the world. Thank you.